Would you like to board a train without knowing where it is going? Well, nobody will. So that's the importance of goals. If you don't have goals, probably you are living your life without knowing where are you heading. Now just imagine a football playground without goals. How can anyone play the match in the absence of goals on both the sides? Unless there is a target, what can you shoot at? Unless the teacher explains what kind of questions he is likely to face in the examination, how can the student prepare? Likewise, it is not possible to achieve anything worthwhile without specifying your personal goals. If you have anything to do significantly, you must not only define but also write them down, the goals. And the goals can be in many areas. How many areas? Number one, everyone should think health is most important. Health is the best gift that nature has given us. So you should write down the health goals. Health goals means how you are going to maintain your health throughout your life, at whatever age you are. After health goals, then career goals. Career goals, it's not that only you have to begin the career and then you are writing the goals. You may be in a senior position. You may have already achieved eminence in certain things, but still, the lifespan that you have, what you are going to do about the career, you should note it down, write it down. Those are your career goals. Then, financial goals. Now, your career and your finance, they are somewhat interrelated. So, you must have specific financial goals. How much money you must have at a particular time, and for that, earning that money, what you are going to do. You should write down, you should not only define, you should write down the plan of action and how you are going to achieve these. Now, after that, you should have family goals defined. Family is very important. Life at home is equally important as life in the office, if not more. So therefore, how you are going to maintain your family, if you have children, how you are going to raise them, what kind of education you propose to give them, how you want that they should be very productive, very focused. So, and that again, you have to now note down, you have to write down your relationship with your wife, with your children, with parents, if you have parents, and also any other important relative that you are concerned from day to day life. After family goals, then you have to note down social goals. We are all living in society. We should know how we have to conduct ourselves in the society that we are living in. So, social goals are also very important. Now, after social goals, then you should have hobby goals. Everyone must have some hobby. Something which you are doing because you like to do, not for any other reason. So, something which you want to do on your own, for yourself. So then, that also you can achieve only if you have defined your goals. So define those. Note down how much time you are going to devote per week or per day, which days, everything you should note down. So those are your hobby goals. And your hobby can be any maybe music, maybe dance, maybe reading, writing, whatever it is. But note down the goals and go as per the plan. Then, after that, then you should have spiritual goals. We know that we are going to stay here for some time. Life is a journey which is bound to end somewhere. The journey, at least of this life, is likely to end. And how we are going to live and how we want the kind of satisfaction, yes, the duty that for which we have come here, the significance of our life, we have done our best to achieve that. So that is the spiritual goal. Now, just writing the goal is not enough. Then you should write a journal every night and contribute to the goals. You should weekly progress or monthly progress or whichever way you have planned out, so that your focus should be on achieving, on making some efforts towards achieving those goals. Now, if you then do that, you will find your life is significant. You will find your productivity will increase. You will find you will be at peace, and that is the way to live a happy life. There will be difficulties. There will be unexpected hiccups, unexpected challenges. But that you have to provide. You have to understand that life is ups and downs. So those things have to be faced courageously. The good thing is, if you have everything written down and if you are pursuing everything from day to day or week to week, then you will not have any difficulty whatsoever in following, pursuing your goals and in taking up the path of pursuing excellence. So this will give you better self-esteem, and you will find yourself, you will start loving yourself, which is very important, which is very important in life. That doesn't mean that you should be arrogant or proud. No, it means that you respect yourself, because if you respect yourself, others will respect you. You respect yourself because you are disciplined, because you are pursuing your goals, because though your goals provide everything around which is important in life. Thank you.